is to get the artwork out there. And how to get it out there is I work primarily with art consultants, but also word of mouth, collector, private collectors, and developers. And my work is throughout the country. The important part of it is to get it out there, not to stay in the basement.
It's an ongoing process of creativity, and there seems to be no end to what it is that his imagination is. It's like almost an imagination running on an imagination. He explains to me, they almost come across like epiphanies. And he's very excited trying to tell me about this imagery. And I'm intrigued, but it's frustrating because I can't see it. So I wish there was like a little door over here so I can crawl in and see what his neurotransmitters are doing. Because I tend to think that it's like a firestorm of color, like fireworks. And so I would like the opportunity to crawl in and see what it is he's seeing, because I'm always fascinated with all the different series of artwork that he's producing. Where does all this imagery come from? How does it come to these?
It's amazing she puts up with me. Why do I do art?
Too many, yeah. It's like, why do you do art? Is that like way too broad of a question?
Right.
So I'm trying to slow down a little because he's got way too much to say.
I know.
I'm afflicted. What can I say? It has to do with being raised in Texas.
Oh, I know. And your mother raised four boys by herself. You went to Van Horn and your grandmother took you for painting lessons and you were the only kid there.
You know the whole story.
I know about Guatemala. I know everything. Oh, that's what happens when you're with somebody who does this. But in his case, he's got one adventure after the next. Are you going to come or you got to say hello?
Hello to
see her.
Artists need to be able to verbalize what they're doing. And this is what I'm explaining, or what I'm talking about, is to verbalize what is on the canvas. What did I intend to do, and what do other people see, is two different things. It can be many different things for what other people can see. The most important part of sharing is to explain or to share the wonderment of everything. The wonderment of what is going on, I want to share with other people. It's part of the whole idea of process of learning and sharing. I think that's the idea of what life is. I spent my summers with my grandparents in a small town in West Texas, Van Horn, Texas, and that's where my grandmother took me to art classes, painting classes. I was 10 years old, and all the other students were 60-year and older women who were painters. But I fell in love with paint. I learned how to mix colors, and from there I was off and running as far as my own personal addiction to painting and dealing with artwork. I took one course in silkscreen, and then a light lit off in my head saying, well, this is even better in the sense I can do more of the same idea and do multiple times over the same image, and no longer would become a monotype, but become a painting. I started out fundamentally just learning about patterns, and pattern being such an important part of our daily comprehension of what we see every day in life. And the pattern of dealing with the silkscreen was to create a fabric line. And that fabric line took hold in San Francisco. I worked out of my garage and created a fabric line that soon grew into a business, a major business, where I took over the top floor of the old Hams Brewery building in South of Market in San Francisco. It was 5,000 square feet. I had 100-foot-long tables and started to do yardage. Doing major installations, including Apple's computer first headquarters in Cupertino. I saw, at the same time, I was also discovering the idea of the painting of the silkscreen. I was more exploring the silkscreen as a painting process. And from there, it took off to a whole different scenario, a whole new different frontier. After a few years in that studio, in the early 80s, I decided that I wanted to concentrate on my artwork. This is a squeegee going through a screen. It's been around for centuries as far as a method of printing in Japan, where it began, and then became very much of a focal point for printing in this country in the turn of the century. All the five and dime signs going up, you know, 5 cents, 10 cents, they were all screened. And it was all done by hand, like we're doing right now.
And so what we're doing, because the screen is so large, is that I'm holding the screen down.
Exactly.
And we're switching hands, and John is holding
it. It has to be fairly seamless in the transfer.
Right. It's almost like a dance.
Yeah, exactly.
We're doing our dance.
You don't know what's going to happen until you pick up the screen and you're saying, wow.
I mean, you kind of set it out. You have your intentions, you have your technique, but ultimately there is that magic that happens.
Yeah.
On its own. But what I love about John's printing is that it's sort of like you get to play, you get to design things. It's so much more liberating and exciting than just perfectly producing
the same thing.
The same thing.
It's
right.
Always been relegated as the printing process, not as a painting process. And this is what I keep repeating myself, I know, but it's an amazing discovery what this vehicle called a screen can do, something much broader than what it was intended
yeah.
for.
So we're breaking the rules.
Being an artist is a very tough road, but there's one thing, the fact is, you can never replace the artist in your creative process. That's how we survive.
And then sometimes we'll do a piece where we use these leftover colors and it just complete spontaneity, you know. You just don't even know what's going to come out. It's so cool.
The direction is of the two diagonal lines coming together in the middle, the quote rock and rolling in the middle. And with the smallest screen, which I call it the crystals, you get this agitation of a visual agitation that's pretty exciting. Change as the spectrum changes of the different colors. So totally unexpected without this light. You would only see what we saw before. So yeah. The next design is going to be the good vibration screens. Mixing it up with the electricity, that's going to be outrageous. When a simple pattern turns into a very complex pattern, perhaps more prominent this way. As you see here, as far as a large scale piece, there's a lot of factors to consider as far as composition. Again, the idea is to get the viewer engaged and stay engaged. In this situation, what I did all these little diagonals. Images underneath, and these I call crystals, the really tiny little lines. Again, these are all hand cut screens, but I layered that down on the black canvas first, and then I built upon it. And the way to tie it all together was to use this spoke starburst kind of idea and make it travel going up and down, and if someone is to walk along this, they would see a path where it began and where it ended. But the main focus is still, and as a center of interest, is where all these elements come together. It's fascinating, especially with this UV process, and even more evident from day to night. And to actually see it go up and down and up and down, it's very playful, it has a lot of motion. And just to do it, something to look at, a lot to look at.